Today we're going to look at MRI of the spine, and in particular facet cysts of the spine. And we'll look at the MRI appearance of them, where to look for them on MR, and what to look for. This was a series we did with Hitachi Medical Systems Singapore on spinal imaging, and this is a portion of that from that web series. So we're going to look at facet cysts today, and what we normally do when we teach is that we start with normal anatomy, because I think normal anatomy is the most important thing. And then once you know what's normal, then you can look at what's abnormal much more confidently. So if we look at the facet joint is basically composed of the joint between the superior articular facet, the inferior articular facet and the superior articular facet, and we have the joint space in between. Now, on MR, what you see is this is a PD signal. This is a PD sequence. So we're seeing intermediate signal on a T1 sequence. You would just see low signal, and on a T2, you may either see a thin amount of fluid in the facet joint, or you may see no fluid in the facet joint at all, and that's the normal appearance. The other important bit is also to look at this. This structure is the ligamentum flavum. So the ligamentum flavum covers the facet joint on its medial side. So we have both a capsule. So this orange arrow is for the capsule. And here we'll have a capsule around the joint. And then this darker structure is the ligamentum flavum. This is a T1 weighted sequence. On T1, it is low signal. So the normal appearance is to have a thin amount of fluid or none at all, and then a thickish black line, which is a ligamentum flavum and capsule. And on the lateral side, we have only capsule. Okay, so where do you get cysts? Cysts are basically due to degeneration of the joint, and you end up with synovial cysts. So there is some connection, often there's a connection between the cyst and the joint. So if we look at this image here, we have a number of locations where the cyst from the facet joint can go. So it can go into the subarticular recess. We'll go into what that is in a moment. So that's basically within the canal. It can sit in the foramen. It can be in this far lateral or extraforaminal region. So that means it's outside the foramen. Or you can get these posterior paravertebral cysts. Now, the importance of this is that depending on where the cyst is sitting, a different nerve root will be affected. And again, we're going to go into which nerve roots will be involved. Okay, so let's look at a normal case to begin with. Okay, so we have, I'm just going to go through the normal anatomy of the locations of where these cysts can occur. So normal facet joint, small amount of fluid, so this is within normal limits. What's abnormal? Well, it's a matter of degree. Okay, so I think this is, you would say, is within normal limits. We'll see some later on where there's more fluid than normal. Ligamentum flavum. The capsule, we don't really see all that well, but so this will be a combination of flavum and capsule. Now, if we look at the location of these cysts, most commonly what these cysts do is that they come out of the facet joint and they will sit in here. So this region is the subarticular or lateral recess. They will be in this portion of the canal. So what does that mean? What does the subarticular lateral recess mean, and how do you find it? So the subarticular or lateral recess, probably the best look anatomical marker is the pedicle. So if you look at the pedicle, this region is the subarticular or lateral recess. And we have a nerve root that goes in there, and that is called the traversing nerve root. So we're here at 5-4-3. So this is the 3-4 level. So this is the 3-4 disc. Now, as you keep coming down, we have two nerve roots. We've got a exiting nerve root, which will be the L3 nerve root. and we have a traversing nerve root, which is the L4 nerve root. We'll come back to this again in a moment, but basically we can have a cyst that sits within the subarticulolateral recess. We can look for cysts within the foramen. We can look for cysts outside here. And the other area which is commonly missed, because we just sort of don't look, not that it's difficult, are posterior paravertebral cysts, which come out of the posterior margin of the joint. And the more important ones are really the ones anteriorly, because they're the ones that can compress nerve roots. Okay, so as we said, cysts within the subarticular or lateral recess, they will affect the traversing nerve roots. So the nerve roots that are within the canal are the traversing nerve roots. Cysts within the foramen. So these will now affect the exiting nerve roots at whatever level you're at. And these are lateral cysts, which will also involve the exiting nerve root. And then these are posterior paravertebral cysts. And they come off, as we said, from the posterior margin of that facet joint. Okay, so we briefly talked about this before, which nerve roots are compressed. So we're at the 3-4 level. The nerve root that's within the canal, the first nerve root. So we've got a whole lot of nerve roots here. And the normal nerve roots, you know, are the like the quadriquina. So they come off sequentially. So this will be the L4 nerve root. This will be the L5 nerve root. So they go out sequentially. So if we're at this L3-4 level, the nerve root that's the first nerve root that's there in the canal is going to be the L4 nerve root. The nerve root that comes out is the L3 nerve root. If we go down to L4-5, here's the L4 nerve root that's gone out. This is the L5 nerve root that's within the canal. This is the traversing nerve root, and this is the one that will get affected if we have a cyst in the subarticular recess. The exiting nerve root will get affected if we have a foraminal cyst. Okay, so we've talked about which nerve roots are involved.